Williamson. I'm being a little bit quiet because my wife is sleeping, but we have a pretty cool show. It's all doing research that I've been working on for a number of weeks now. And what it is, let's tilt this light so you guys can see me a little bit better. So what it is I am trying to take filter floss samples. And after the filter floss, I'll show you guys what I'm doing. And then we're going to go under the microscope. But if you guys want to chat, hang out while we're doing it, great. The more, the better. So it's good to see you guys. Pete, Thomas, J-Man, Midnight Lobster, Sam, good to see you guys. So let me show you what I'm working on. All right. So what we have going on here is we have filter floss from a number of aquariums. And you can see how they get dirtier. Well, these are filters that I changed exactly 2 weeks ago now as of today. So these are going to be filters running in aquariums that are progressively older. So it goes, and there's one curveball in there, which is, so it's a 2 weeks, 3 months, and then another 3 months. But this 3 months, the third one in, it has been seeded. So that means that I used plants and substrate from another aquarium. So I want to see how much it has actually clung on to the fibers of the filter floss. And then we've got 3 year, one year, 3 year, and 5 years. And then we also have samples from each aquarium out of six and pond green water. So we'll be definitely seeing some interesting stuff under the microscope. The other thing that we have going under the microscope that we should look at first is what you see here. These two are visible by the naked eye, and that is out of my pond that I feed my fish with. So we're going to set that up on the slide, or up on the stage first. And these are just really informal wet slides, so they're not super fancy. But last week I took samples of all the same filters, and what I did was I took a razor blade and I scraped any diatom algae or dust off of the tank, off the sides of the tank. Then I took a scraping from wood or some other hard surface. I took a scraping of this dirty stuff here, and I've looked at all these things separate, but what I wanted to do is just make a big sample of the different biomes in each tank. And so it's a mix. And then the other thing I did was I just took a sample of some algae somewhere in the tank. Usually it was the filter outflow or the slide way. So that spillway or slideway of the tank, I took a lot of samples from there. So welcome, guys. We'll be hanging out. And the first thing we're going to look at, like I said, is going to be those little copepods, because they're alive. And I know they're teeny, and I know we're going to be looking at lots of stuff that's alive. But I want to keep those things alive as much as possible. So this can take just a second sometimes. And by a second, I mean like 2 or 3 minutes when I get the camera mounted right and set up. Hopefully it'll go quicker than that this time. But it's good to see you. Shanna, what's up? Pansy American, Aquaballs, John Monroe, Ian, what's up, dude? And Dan, welcome. 4:30, you must be on the East Coast. See, I do this, I'm trying to stream more at night for various people that may not be in the United States as well. So let me get this lifted as well so that it doesn't backslide on me, and so we can keep it in focus. So now that we've got this, there's like a torque to this that some, there we go. We're getting there, guys. I think we're gonna dial it in quick tonight. So, and I think, did I leave the stage dim, or the aperture, I mean? I think it's up all the way. Okay. So let's keep that this way so we can make sure we're getting a clean view down the scope. Let me tighten all these little levers. There we go. All right, and now we just have to focus the camera. All right, so you guys saw what this was, which is a slide, and it had some stuff on it, and it had some little creepy crawlies on it. It had what I said were Daphnia. I misspoke. They're Cyclops. Let's get rid of that blob of. There we go. And let's scoot this a little bit farther, so that our camera is completely centered. This harness is kind of a weird deal, the way it, right before it's completely focused, it's completely unfocused. So it's kind of a pain in that respect. All right, there we go. Now we're centered. Now we're cooking with gas, guys. We just need to focus the microscope. Hey, Only Oscars, what's up? And JMN says, prime time. So right now we're at 200 times magnification. Let's show you guys the critters that you could actually see with your bare eyes, with the naked eye. Oh, there it goes. It might be so big that it doesn't even make sense to look at under the microscope, but I wanted to try to catch these for you guys, because Cyclops are pretty cool, and I thought maybe they'd have some babies in the water for us. Oh, we got a little worm. And you guys saw that this is just a little smudging of algae. We'll take a break at about, you know what, I'll say in 13 minutes we'll take, or no, 23 minutes we'll take a break, and we'll look at everything again. Or you can rewind to the beginning, but that way people later watching this can see what I'm looking at and what I'm taking note on later slides. Now, this stuff's all from the pond outside. Crispy video looks good in 720. It should be HD, but I don't know what that means coming from the microscope and, you know, playing with all the light and everything. Probably downgrades it. All right. So you can see all the life that's in a pond. I mean, it's insane. Come on, focus. Focus. There we go. So you can see that greenish colored stuff. And when I take the light away, you can see how much life is actually in the water. That's the finer particles of stuff. Now the moving stuff is all living. It's all little creatures and life forms, like algae. And this is single cell algae, the green ones. And you can see, look, there's like a little worm that's coming out of, it looks like a little brontosaurus or something. You can see there's a hair of, oh, I went the wrong way. So needless to say, you would not want to drink this pond water, considering that it looks pretty darn clear to the naked eye, minus any clump of something. But you would think, oh, that's totally filtered water, easily. I mean, you could be tricked. So let's find the guys zooming around and a clump that's sure to be full of life. So here we can see there's fungi growing. You can see the little fine hairs of it. That's the hyphae or mycelium. And because this isn't mounted flat, there's different depths of sight and different depths of field that we're looking at. But again, this is all on basically half a grain of rice is what this whole clump is. And the center's too dense to really see very well. But this is all going to be types of like pond life that came out of a Seattle backyard pond. Now here we can see there's blackbeard algae out there, or cyanobacteria. It's hard to know, but some sort of black algae. There's also plenty of filamentous and hair type algae. Let's focus again. And lots of little protists. And protists are the little round dudes swimming around that, and also looks like maybe those aren't paramecium. Those look more like nematodes or flatworms. But they are a probably a single cell organism. So we've seen all them. Let's look at the dude who is just swimming around. Boy, I wonder if he has an illness or if that's normal. Look at this. He's covered in algae. Looks like he has a fungal infection. Hey, Baharath, is that how you say that? I'm sorry if I'm saying that wrong. Hope you are doing good. Great content. You are inspiring me halfway across the globe in India. Right on. Good to hear, man. I have a quick question. Do you need to use fertilizer for a seasoned tank at all? It's a good idea if you end up having high light and wanting to grow and trim lots of plants. If you're growing low light plants and you don't really want to trim that much and the density isn't insane, then you're okay. Oh, he's alive. I think he's sick though. Look at this. I think he has a fungus of some sort. Or maybe it's just his exoskeleton has algae and fungi on it, but he's actually got little critters that seem to be cleaning him or eating chunks of stuff off of him. So this is a male. These come in genders. And it looks like he's got a cyanobacteria or some sort of, it could be a protease too, but it really almost looks like a fungus to me all over his exoskeleton, which is interesting. So let's find the female. There's a female in here and she's got the big old eggs on her, which you'll see what I mean. So that was the male. And the female, oh, here she is. She's cruising fast. Let's see. Female, she doesn't like the warmth of the light from the brightness probably. So I'm trying to snag her up on something so that we can continually watch her. All right, let's see, where'd she go? Is she caught up on here somewhere? So there we go. There's the female. Look at all those babies. So this is why the cyclops, why they look like this, why they have the dot and then the antenna you can usually see with your bare eyes just barely. Well, they have those giant sacks of eggs on the females. Now we're at 200 times magnification, which is probably too much for this gal, and we're really seeing and Sam, I didn't find out what those retracting things were. Someone said that they could be a bryozoa, like a sponge. Someone else, also both ichthyologists said that they could also be something like a freshwater sea anemone relative, or a tube worm relative, like fan worms, but that doesn't help us much. So what I'm going to do is I have a microbiologist and saltwater plankton, but they know a good amount about freshwater plankton too. And I'm going to ask her. It's my, one of my wife's friends has a degree in oceanography and planktonics, I guess. I think that's what it's called. Which I'd never heard of, but she used to categorize and catalog footage of plankton for a living. So hopefully she can tell us something more. Where did the female go? She totally zipped out of our sight. But This is the pond water, so this isn't really comparable to our aquarium necessarily. This has a lot of outside influences. You're going to see a lot more, especially if we were to go in like 400 times. I mean, look at all that life. Every layer is packed full of life. You've got fungi, you've on the edges of this algae stuff. You've got a little teeny single cell protease. You got amoebas, you've got more fungi, we've got algae, we've got more protozoa, just all sorts of life at 400 times zoom. And we're just looking, I mean, this is not even the head of a pin that we're looking at right here. That is one string of filamentous hair algae that we're looking at. But what I'm going to be interested in is what we're doing next tonight, which is we are looking at the difference between different ages of substrate, or of filter media, rather. So here you can see some of the dead cyanobacteria or single cell bacteria. Oh, there's another one of those little cups. So see this, it looks like a stentor, but it's not. It doesn't move. But see how it's sucking in? Can you guys see that? We're going to zoom into about 800 times here. So see how this thing has little flagella, little things, and it's little little wings almost, or little paddles, and it's sucking in algae and very small single cell life forms into that cup. See, it's in its stomach right there. Its whole body is a stomach. It's very cool. And again, you can see, like, here comes a little protozoa of some sort cruising by. So I do have to say that the pond life is pretty freaking fascinating. And when we're just looking at little clumps of what you would think would be nothing. Again, at the half hour mark of the show, I will zoom in, or I mean, I will unzoom. I will show you guys what we're looking at. And we'll get the female back under the slide again for you guys now. She's gonna take off because she hates it under the heat of the thing. And I feel bad for her, like, being on this slide. I know they're a simple creature and I'm feeding them to fish all day, but I still feel bad. I can't help it. Where'd she go? She's gonna be giant. After looking at all these tiny things, she's gonna be ginormous. There she is. All right, so that's her. We can see her body. I mean, look at that. You can see her stomach, maybe? I don't know. I'm a little curious if she's about to shed her exoskeleton after she has those eggs. That's curious. We'll have to zoom in a little bit more in a second here. So I'm in no way an expert on this stuff. I am just learning now, and I'm just notating what I see. But here we can see that this, okay, so that's probably where she's going to the bathroom, that stuff there. And maybe those are her little swimmerettes. Yeah, so I don't have even 1,000 times zoom here on this microscope. So for archaea and bacteria, I have played with stains, but they don't make a huge difference. I still just see, like, fuzziness. but in any case, each of those is an egg on her, and she'll have them hatch off of her. Now, what's surprising to me is how beat up these ones look. Generally, their exoskeletons are really shiny and good-looking, but I think these may have some sort of parasite. Let's go look at the male again to compare anatomy. So here's the male. Yeah, so that red stuff is just waste. And I'm guessing that underneath them, oh, he moved. Come on, dude. I'm guessing underneath them we're seeing maybe their swimmerettes through their body that's making that motion too, as well as some sort of, you know, heart or organ like that. But boy, let's zoom in again, see if he'll stay still for it. Probably not. And look at that. What's all over him is definitely like, it looks like ileobiopsidae. Look at that. It's eating through his exoskeleton, it looks like, or eating off the chitin rather than protecting the chitin. I mean, he's got chunks missing. That is really fascinating. And it looks like, yeah, I don't know. I would love to hear from somebody who's more of an expert on this, but you can see the algae. That doesn't surprise me a ton. Here's a paramecium that's living next to it that just went out of focus. Different depths, though. I mean, look at its antenna. It's just got algae all over it. And it's got another little, this is a stentor living on it right here on its side that'll put out a cord and then it'll eat like a cup, that little clear thing on the bottom there. But look on its antennae. That is some gnarly algae. I can't believe that this is a healthy one. All the other ones I've ever looked at are very healthy and shiny. And I mean, they look like they have armor on. This guy looks like he's been eaten alive by algae and bacteria. I don't know if that's like an end of the life cycle thing or if these are infested. But that's good to know, because I wouldn't want to introduce these into the ones in my aquaria that are healthy. I need to do some research and find out what the possible reasons for this appearance are. But, okay, we've probably had enough fun looking at these little guys. But, man, look at that. So they're actual moving. Some of the little algae things are moving. See, they're arranging themselves. So I think it's a cyanobacteria, perhaps, or also known as a blue-green algae, but it's just conjecture. I don't know for sure. We need an expert. And there's definitely fungi on him. No, you can see, I mean, you can see this creature without the microscope. Hold on. You can see this creature pretty clearly without the microscope. He's about a millimeter. Usually it looks like they have armor. You can Google cyclops, and this is what the males look like. And again, then we'll slide over, and the females, where'd she go? They're in a puddle on this slide. I don't like to mount them and kill them if I can help it. So then the female looks like this, but you can also see something has taken a bite out of those eggs. Usually she stacks those eggs up like perfectly, but there's some missing. And then they've got their long tail. And then they've got their eye organ. But these guys, I mean, they're a cyclops. Yeah, and they do kind of look like silverfish or, you know, but I think that algae, I think that's something dangerous for them. All right, well, let's slip this out. Is it Andrea or is it Andrea? From Italy. Hello to Italy. Good to see you. All right, so that was interesting and all. Now I'm kind of afraid of it. I feel like now I don't want it in my house. That's what happens when you look at these slides for too many hours, is you just realize that the world is covered in life. All right, so let's look at the filters now. So these we may have to do a little bit of searching just to find the depth of field. But this is going to be the this is going to be the filter oh, thank you, Freshwater Ichthyology, you're joining us. Eye spots are ocilia, but they are the most simple eyes, often only able to distinguish light and dark. Yeah, and I've noticed that on some forms of the Cyclops, they are compound, like there's a bunch of cells together there, in lenses almost of some sort, and in others, not so much. So let me read off to you guys in order as we look at these, which filters they are. And again, I just haven't cleaned these for 2 weeks. The tanks, however, are the thing that's the different age. The filter floss is a constant in a hang off the back filter on each tank. So what we're looking to see is the amount of life, bacteria, and how much, if any, wear and tear on the filter floss there is. But in this, we're definitely seeing some single cell algae, some obviously bacteria, some maybe filaments of fungi or of the material. It's hard to know. Looks like a fungi. So then here's some little chunks of malm. If we're looking through, and let's look at the darkest part of this sample. And guys, this sample is the one that is 2 weeks old. This is a brand new aquarium. So we don't see much of any life other than algae, bacteria, archaea, you know, the standard stuff that's on a lot of surfaces that is going to be a lot smaller than we can manage here. But you see some poop and mulm, and here's some a leaf of duckweed. This is going to be duckweed at 200 times magnification. So let's go to the next sample. There's really not much to see or tell there. So then this is the next sample, which is going to be 3 months old, but this one I used aquarium water and hardscape from a tank that is 2 or 3 years old. So this is the one in the lake inlay tank aquarium. And here you definitely see a lot more strains of algae. To me, it looks like less bacteria or less fungi growth, just at a glance. Less of the hair, crystalline hair things that are networked, and the filaments still look pretty clear, and they're not breaking down or anything like that. They're just doing their thing. But again, I still am not seeing a whole lot of life in this little sample. So let's slide over to the 3 months no filter start. So this sample I would expect to be the least of all of them or equal to the first one. Then we'll get to the interesting ones. But I'm not finding anything other than debris, really. Oh, we got something here. What is this? A little worm? A little paramecium or worm? A little nematode maybe? Some little clear worm. Doesn't look like a flat worm, but I don't know. Munching on something, and he's in that twist of mulm on here. And again, this is only the newest of the samples. This is a only a few week old aquarium, and it does have some older plants, but I didn't try to jump start it per se. So we see filamentous algae. We don't even see a lot of bacteria, or we don't even see a lot of the fungi growth or even differentiating the mulm that much. Let's scoot up to 1 year. That's where I figured we'd start to see some differences in both material composition and composition. Yeah, here we go. All right, let's see here. So this is year old filter material. Or at least the tank is. The filter material is only 2 weeks old. But this is a lower pH tank too. And you can see that the filter material actually has some dents and dings in it on certain spots, which is probably because the acidity, I would guess. I don't know. Or something's chomping on it. But again, we don't really have a whole lot of crazy life forms on here, but we do have a lot more bacteria, and the actual filters, the filaments themselves, have some substantial mulm and life, and I think I do see something moving. Where is it? Where is it? We got to find the depth that it's at, guys. These are all wet slides. There's something moving down in there. So again, a few single cell organisms, I suppose. Some algae. There we go. We got blackbeard algae. We got the dark hair algae that looks like a train. And not a ton of fungi, though, which is interesting to me. The newer samples had a lot of fungi on them, a lot of the fuzzies. But these guys don't. Not a lot of little protists or anything either, although these are not soaking. So, I mean, maybe they are more active when they're soaked. Let's move up to the three-year-old aquarium and see what it is working on. So again, you can see that the filter floss, even though it's only been in the tank for 2 weeks, it's stained darker already. So we have a much darker stain to it. And when we get through these, I'm going to show you guys them out from under the microscope again so you can see what we're looking at. And then we'll look for more crazy aquarium and pond life. Now that looks like, I can't tell if that's just a frayed fragment of something or if that's some sort of fungal growth. It's interesting. But oh, we can start to see now, we can start to see that there are single cell organisms living on this sample at 3 years. So let's zoom in even more. Because I could see them zipping around even when we were at 200 times zoom. Now we're at 400. And definitely some sort of little protists, I would assume, are cruising by slowly. And look at all that growth on the actual filaments. There's a lot of life on there, and that is going to be nitrifying bacteria is going to be part of that ecosystem, which to me is just cool to see. And the mulm is much more intense, a lot more of the brown mulm. But you know, the filter floss itself is not extremely full of life. I kind of expected it to be. And that is what I've noted the last few weeks, is that the filter floss is not full of fauna so much. You do find the algae, and obviously there's going to be the nitrifying bacterias and archaea and other life forms like that on all over the surface area. But as far as what we're seeing 400 times zoomed in on a microscope, not a lot of action. A little more on this 3-year-old sample, but more so just in the color of the sample and more diversity in materials, not necessarily in scooting around life forms that we're seeing. Now we do have a 5-year-old sample that we're going to look at too, but I wanted to kind of just zoom around here and see anything. Now I feel like we should go back to the reference point real quick. So the 3-week-old fibers in a brand new tank. That's quite the difference, isn't it, guys? And we know that nitrifying bacteria is a good chunk of what is making up that difference. But at 2 weeks in a new tank, yeah, you've got algae starting to grow and come in, but the fibers themselves, the surface area is only starting to build up. And then we scoot into, say, even a year-old tank. Let's take a look at these fibers. And already those fibers are starting to gain a lot of texture. And that means more surface area. That means more food, especially for eukaryotic creatures. And you got little things. It could be scales of some sort of cell. I don't know. And what is that? Can we focus on it? I guess we're not going to get that. We're not going to get that lucky today, folks. But definitely a whole new range of life is living on these. And different colors. You can see the algae, the cyanobacteria, Less of the fungus, though. Definitely less of the fungus. At least in the form with hyphae and mycelia. There may be some that has more. So now let's kick it up. Let's go back down to magnification. And let's look at a 5-year-old sample right now. Now, that looks like some fungi funk right there. There is a lot of fungi in here. There's also a lot of algae filaments in here. And I don't know if it's some other form of life, maybe freshwater ichthyology, maybe Rebecca knows. Looks like fungi to me, though. At least on land, that's what that would look like. The hyphae or the mycelium of it. Also, I see algae, green algae. I thought I saw something moving. Yeah, there's something moving right there. Where'd it go? Is it a mite? Is it a. What is it? There's something moving in here, folks. This is 5-year-old filter floss. Now, again, it's only 2-week-old filter floss, but the tank it's in is 5 years old. But there's something under there. Let's keep searching it and see. We've got about a grain of, well, about 2 or 3 grains of rice size sample of each filter. So let's take a look around and see if we see any other critters. And again, look at that. That's heavy fungus. So I'm really wondering what the role of mycorrhizal relationships are. Let's zoom out a little bit. That is a lot of fungal growth. That's really interesting. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, maybe you're right, Dan. You could maybe get. And hello, Wayne Talbot. How's it going, man? It's interesting. The floss, the filter floss, you'd think that the rigidity of it might be compromised over time. These are all just 2-week-old filter floss. But in the older ecosystems, you can definitely see that the stuff clogs them up quickly. You know, the stuff in the water clings on quicker. And actually breaks it down or builds it up, it's not really getting a ton of micro particles colonizing or clumping or anything in between the filaments. Like, yes, algae and stuff gets tangled in there, but we're not really seeing what we're seeing is like fungi growing across it and algae like trapped on it and mulm on each filament. We're not really seeing big old amounts of it. Now, that does change. I know when you have filter floss that you haven't changed in weeks, you get anchor points. And again, this is the 5-year-old sample. Filter floss is 2 weeks old. The tank it was in is 5 years old. But again, not a lot of micro flora on here, which really shocks me because just even a little eyedropper of water from the substrate of your aquarium is just completely packed with life. And we'll look at that after this break where I show you guys all the samples again. But so, yeah, I mean, here you can see some detritus and things that clumped up and that formed kind of a clot. And there's some growth of something very dark and black. And some of the hair actually, or some of the filaments, looks pretty haggard. Now, I don't know if when this is underwater and completely submerged, if this is all doing a different role. But again, look at this. You've got these feathers of filament from fungi. And I have to believe that this fungi is playing a huge role in our aquariums, whatever it is that it's doing. Because look at it all on the old tank, which is a very healthy tank. It's definitely there compared to, again, let's look at like a 1-year-old tank. Or better yet, even newer than that. We're scanning back through time, guys. So the new filter flosses,
Yeah, I think, you know, I think we're missing some of the life because this is the end of the slide is the only one that has water on it still. So I think we are kind of just losing, since I prepared these before the show, I think we are losing some of our critters. But this newer filter floss, here you can see that you're getting, and that's because I just touched the water with my thumb, but here you can see that you're not getting a whole lot of texture on the filter floss. You're not getting those big clots and clogs. You're getting, here's a little bit of, that's interesting. This is a different fungi though, but it is fungi, but it's different fungi than we were getting on the 5-year-old tank. This isn't like shards of, it looks like fiberglass. This is more like semi-sporadic spurs that are here and there. That's probably fish. Is that fish poo? I don't know. No, it might just be a line that's in the weird light. And again, we're getting lots of more algae. There's filamentous hair algae right there. But yeah, and it looks like even some moss that got a particle stuck and trapped on it. But that's the one that was pre-seasoned, but it's young, if that makes sense. And then the very newest stuff, again, we have some fuzzies on it. We actually have some little inchworm type critter right here. Check this out. Almost looks like a little leech or something. It's not, I'm sure it's way too small. But we've got some little critter here. And this is on one of the newest samples. But if I had to say a trend, the trend would definitely be more algae, more of one kind of fungi. See this kind of crisscross patchworks of fungus. And we're seeing a lot of little worm type critters. What is this critter? Trying to focus it. Is this like some sort of little mite? Or it's just a little. Probably a little protozoa of some sort. But when we were looking in pond water, this stuff was everywhere. Those little life forms were everywhere. And here, again, the new tanks look really plasticky with a little bit of growth of some fungi, and we keep seeing little like worm. Oh, what is that? Let's scoot that over again. What made that move? Are we way out of focus? Is this on a different level than we're working on? Let's see. No, I think it's somewhere around here. I don't know, something moved in there. There's a little arm or feeler that's moving in there. Yeah, there it is. I'm wondering if that's a scud that's stuck in there, kind of wrapped up in there. Yeah, filter floss is very smooth, which seems like a poor choice of material to me. But then again, I mean, look at what it looks like when we get up to the filter floss that's in the tank with the older stuff. It's still pretty smooth. But you start getting a lot more texture on it as your tank is seasoned, and those different bacteria that have probably flourished that learn how to survive on it start doing so. And then it also, I guess the idea of it is more to catch clumps in between the floss, whereas it's not until you get a more diverse and mature system that you start getting the actual filaments being roughed up and growing different diverse substances, which I think is pretty interesting. Also, I think it's really interesting how intensely covered this is in fungi roots or mycelia and hyphae or mold compared to the new slides. It's a different species too, for sure. I mean, I don't even know what it is, but it's a different species. Just looking at it, you can tell. And again, we've got some other little critter making movement. at some level of magnification, but it's decided to burrow underneath all this other junk. But this is the oldest slide that we'll end on. Oh, what is that? A planaria? I see a shadow of some sort. Oh, it's some sort of worm that's eating detritus. Don't know what. All right, so let's pop out of here again. Okay, we're way too zoomed in. Life on the micro side of things. Okay, so what we were just looking at again, set this here. What we were just looking at was, let me bring the light over so you guys can see it better. So we have filter floss from different tanks. And that last slide was this one here. Then the 3 year, the 2 week old, and then the 2 week old seeded. Lots of algae. You can even see that with your bare eye. You can see the amount of algae that's in there. And that's interesting to me. You can see the black beard, or rather staghorn algae, and a little clump of moss that were in the 3 month old that wasn't seeded, whereas we had a diversity of algae in the seeded one. So that diversity didn't allow one to take over the thread. And then 1 year, it didn't seem to have a huge difference, whereas the 3 year and the 5 year really start building complex aufuchs and layers. We didn't see a ton of little microfauna, but this is filter floss. The water is very different. When we scrape surfaces and get cultures, we've already looked at these, and we know these correspond to each of the tanks that I took the filter samples from. We know for a fact that these have all sorts of critters living in them from this week's microscope sessions. Now, to look at, again, oh, it just dropped it off the slide. Sorry, buddy. But there's that female that we saw the eggs on. That's how big she is. So yes, you can see it with the naked eye, those eggs in her shape, but she's still pretty darn small. Like, here's a pen. She's still very small. And the male is on the glass. Sorry to hear about your quarry eggs. Sometimes if you just turn down the acidity, bring the amount of acidity up, rather, that'll help. Now, here is the little male, and I'm zoomed in quite a bit with my phone just to show you guys this. Let me bring the tip of the ballpoint pen out because it's even smaller than that. So he's smaller than the tip of that, yet he took up the whole magnifying area. So this is the size of life we're looking at, just to keep things in perspective. So, yeah. Well, guys, I think I need to clean up and also kind of prepare some more slides. I might be back later tonight because I need to look at these slides next and look at all the life, because we know there's a diversity of life. And this time I did it on purpose, where I actually cut a snip of filter floss, just a teeny one. I cut, I took some filter, whatever pond protein was floating, and then I did mulm, or whatever was at the bottom. And then I also did scrapings off any wood, glass, and stone. This is the newest tank. I mean, you can see the difference already. And then the one that is new but was spiked, again, algae bloom, pretty apparent. And then the new, the 3 month old, algae and moss starting to grow. The 1 year old, not a ton of stuff, but there is starting to be some clumps of the green. Maybe it's a cyanobacteria. Then we get to the last two, which is we have the 3 year old tank, which definitely there's a lot of greenness to the water, which when we look under the microscope, it will just be alive with movement. And then the 5 year old tank,
has a little bit of everything. Brown, purple, bluish green, green, filament from fungi. So I don't know. I think this, I just wanted to bring you guys along on the ride for how I'm doing this, and it's nothing officially scientific, but I'm having fun doing it, and I figured I'd show you guys what I'm doing so that when I make an assertion like, well, new filter floss tends to not have that much surface area in use, it's more for polishing the algae and the chunks of debris out of your aquarium, you guys will know why I came to that position without having to read literature or anything. That's just my opinion from looking at this tonight, and seeing repeating this same kind of thing over and over. So yeah, if the floss wasn't smooth, it would probably clog up in a few days. You're right, Sam. I bet you're right. It'd be cool to see some snail eggs under a microscope. So I have some snail eggs in these samples from these next set of tanks, and I have a baby Madaka rice fish egg also. Actually two, one that's a week old and one that's 2 weeks old. So I've done that before under microscope. If you look up my other videos with microscope in the title, you'll probably find them. But tonight I wanted to solve this filter floss issue, or at least deepen the mystery and solve what does it look like under the microscope at 200 and 400 times magnification. So thanks guys for tuning in, especially all you Europeans, Indians, Asians, Africans, Aussies. Love to see people from around the world joining in and chiming in. Have a good day, everybody, and all you late night folks too, thank you. And members, thank you so very much for the support. If you want to become a member, there's a link in the description. It's $1.99 and you support this kind of stuff and what it costs me to do this kind of stuff plus just living. So thank you so much guys, I appreciate it. I'm gonna sign off for now and clean up some of the mess that I have here. Clearly I don't want to be touching my mouth or anything after some of these, especially the pond one, or the 5-year-old one. Yeah, so I'll check in again later tonight if we do more work under the scope, because might as well stream it, why not? And if I don't, I'll see you guys soon. And I hope you guys enjoyed tonight. I know it was a little boring to come to this conclusion, but I think there's some pretty big thoughts to be drawn of how to make your filters after what we saw tonight. Lorna, hello, thank you so much for coming by and for all you do to support the channel. Thank you. It's good to see you. All right, guys, well, I'm going to clean up this mess, like I said. I'm going to also maybe set some new slides, get some new samples, and return the little swimmy critters to whence they came, including those ones that seem to look infected that fell off the slide in this box over here. Love to know from someone else later if they watch the replay or if they watch this and they know what was going on with those copepods, or rather the cyclops, and why they were covered in that crusty algae. Looked like a parasite to me, but maybe I'm wrong. All right, guys, have a good one. Take it easy, and we'll look at lots of swimmy dealies and identify lots of species the next time this microscope is on. Have a good one. Bye.